record some ambience and put it in this track.
Guys, Jen here of Gadget Pilipinas. Welcome back to the channel. So today, pag-usapan natin tong bagong controller ni Gamesphere, and this is the Gamesphere GA+. This video is not sponsored by Gamesphere. I just thought of buying this because this has been being discussed actually on YouTube, on websites, and gusto ko malaman no, kung mag-work ba to flawlessly on my two smartphones. I have the Magic V3 right over here, and also I have the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Before we start, let's go ahead and unbox first the Gamesphere GA+. I'll walk you through muna yung pinaka-box niya para alam natin, no, parehas nating malaman kung ano ba yung mga other features ito na even ako hindi ko alam before I even bought it. So, sale kasi siya, kaya I got up and then really bought this because nasa 2.6 na lang siya from 2.999. So, 300 pesos din yun, no? So, this is the box of the GA+, Galileo Wireless Mobile Game Controller. As you can see, these are the features that we need to know. It contains the following things. Ano ba yung mga features niya? May analog saka digital triggers. Pwedeng palitan at interchange yung kanyang mga keys. And hall effects na rin yung kanyang joystick, which is actually very nice kasi kung worried ka about stick drift, that is a good solution for you because this one is already using hall effect joysticks. This is a cool way of showing you the features of this joystick. And on this side naman, you have some Discord community. Maybe this is for the application and some barcodes and stuff. Okay, alam ko marami sa inyo naghihintay. Mag-unbox na ako kasi dami ko pa sinasabi. So let's go ahead and do it. There you go. Mukhang okay na yan. Let's just put this right here. There. So we have a box here. Tapos syempre, meron pang box sa loob. It says here, beyond boundless, where possibilities know no limits. Ooh, there you go. GA+, Galileo. We have a smaller box, maybe that contains the manuals and cables. Yep. We have a cable right here. I like the texture of the cable. Lengthwise, hindi siya ganun kahaba. Alright, let me just go and test it out. Or check it out, rather. Sakto lang yung haba. Hindi siya ganun kahaba, pero okay na. Okay. We have the manuals right over here. Plus sticker, which we can put on some stuff. And a quick start guide, I believe. Ayan. And also some QR codes if you have some questions about the product. And we have here the manual. Nothing else inside. And ito na, no? Interchangeable yung kanyang mga joysticks. So depende kung ano ang gusto mo. If you want something with a smaller joystick or maybe a little bit wider, yung stem din niya, yung length ng stem can also be picked kung ano ang gusto mo. There's a shorter stem, there's a longer stem. You have basically three choices for this. I like the fact that they also have some protection for the joysticks. And starting to light up. We'll set this aside for now kasi gusto natin makita pa yung ibang mga laman. No? Kung meron man. Alright, that's it. It's pretty much everything inside the box of the Galileo GA+. So, basically you have the cable that I mentioned earlier. You also have here the controller. You have here three joysticks. If you wish to change it, you have the quick start guide and also some maybe guides if you want to contact Gamesphere. Alright, quick demo. We have here the joystick, both are Hall effects. We have here the D-pad and also the face buttons right over here. We have select, I believe this is select, but it says here minus and plus. And we have maybe mode select and another one here, which I do not know. Let's check it out. Oh, capture button and modifier. So these are capture buttons and modifier. This is its home button. And here sa baba, meron dito ngayon na pairing button at saka yung kanyang Type-C na port. So should you want to pair it with your devices, dyan na yan. And that's pretty much everything. Oh, at the back, meron tayong modifiers dito. There are two. And length. Yan, yun yung length niya, no? Ganyan siya kahaba. But people have been doing this. Yan. So, yun yung ginagawa nila. So, there's one way for you to do that. Just, you can actually extend it even further para magkasya yung ibang mga tablets na meron ka. Pero after that, you have to make sure na dumikit uli siyang ganoon. Because if you try to do that, aangat yung nandito, but you're able to extend the controller even further, which is nice. And then after that, balik mo lang uli siya. Ayan. Ayan. And then after that, dito sa gilid, you have to press it para to, you know, to hold it in place again. Which is actually very nice for games here to really think about. Kasi kahit na yung advertised claim niya would be only until here, this much or this wide, you can still further extend it if you want to, which is a plus point for games here. Now, I like this option because some controllers, kapag bumili ka, it's either yung Type-C niya is nandito on the right side or Type-C niya is on the left side. That is a bit of a concern, especially for some people kasi they don't want their smartphones kapag nasa right side yung Type-C, the phone, for example, for foldable smartphones, the phone would extend down because usually yung placement ng port ng Type-C ng device would be at the top. So, awkward yung itsura niya kapag nangyari yun. But there's also one way naman na ginawa naman ni Gamester with this one, yung X2S, nasa left side naman yung kanyang Type-C, which is also okay. But people do not want this in a way because ayun nila kadalasan nang meron pang sinasaksak na Type-C dun sa telepono nila. Some prefer Bluetooth connectivity, which the Gamester G8 Plus offers. In this case, no, I have two devices here. We have here the Magic V3, no? And we have also here the iPhone 15 Pro Max. So these are two devices, and we're gonna test out if this is going to work on the Magic V3 very easily and without any issues, and also on the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Now let me show you this, no? With the Magic V3, you can actually put this on, but of course, with the case, medyo naka-protrude siya ng konti because in the case of the Magic V3, yung kanyang camera ring is a little bit protruded. Kaya nang sa ganoon, kapag ka nilagay mo siya on this side, it's not gonna hold pretty well. Alright? So, without the case, the back case, ganun pa rin. Okay? Pero, we can do this instead. Oh, sorry. There you go. Hindi na ngayon issue yung protruding na camera ring because it is now at the top. But if ito meron siyang Type-C on the right side, you don't have a choice but to put or to bring the phone a little bit down para nasaguro masaksak mo siya dun sa Type-C port niya, no? Now, this is a good thing for me because I'm gonna be using the phone like so, no? Ganito yung itsura niya. Which is nice, di ba? Oh, there you go. Ah, cool. Go ahead and check this out. Can we do it easily? There. And that. And magnet yung plate niya. Ah, nice! Okay, let's do it again. Now, it seems to see na yung aking keyboard, joy controller rather, is using a PlayStation controller. I'm not sure if there's a way for us to change that. And that's only probably when we download the app. So let's go ahead and download the Games Here app. Not connected. Button settings. Xbox. There you go. Xbox layout. Switch layout. And we can also do button mapping. Like what happens if I press L4 and then R4 at the back. And joystick settings. I can also, you know, set the dead zone if I want to. The dead zone is just okay. Nothing wrong with that. And then the game mode support joystick. Let's press this button. We should be able to further expand the use of our controller. There you go. Yan. So, ayun na. Nakalagay na. Y saka B. Correct. So, as you can see, it is now showing yung tamang layout ng controller, which is the Xbox layout. So, yun. So, that is, of course, how this works on, at least on the Magic V3 right over here. It is working flawlessly on the Magic V3. We're able to download the Games Here app as well. And as you can see, we will be able to map things out, like for the L4 and R4, and swap the joystick as well, which is really nice. Now, let's go ahead and download the Games Here app naman on the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Okay, so ayan na siya ulit. Controller testing. Not working here, at least from my end. Joystick settings, not working as well. Now, one reason here is that I'm using iOS 18. I'm using public beta of iOS 18. That might be the case. And likely there is incompatibility with the Games Here app or maybe with this controller. That's something that we will need to check out later on. So hopefully when iOS 18, the real one, you know, the non-beta one drops, pwede natin gamitin ito. No? Pero for now, I cannot confirm if iOS 18 is compatible with Games Here G8 Plus. That's something that remains to be checked later on. But for the sake of my clarity and for the sake of really me knowing if this really is working or not, I'm going to do a quick restart of my phone. No? That might actually be the reason, no, for this not working on the iPhone 15 Pro Max. But at least we're able to check na gumagana siya on the Magic V3 or on other, I would suppose, on other Android devices. But for now, no, we're gonna wait for a bit and let's see if gagana uli ito. I restarted my phone. It's running on iOS 18 public beta. Let's see kung ano ang mangyayari. Okay, let's go ahead and fire up Games Here again. And let us connect our phone to this controller. And hopefully, gumana na siya. But if not, then that means it's a confirmation that iOS 18 is not compatible with Games Here G8 Plus. Okay, so it is still not working on the iOS 18 on my iPhone 15 Pro Max. Let us disconnect this for now. Okay, let's now use this and connect it to our laptop. Kasi isa na naman yan na po pwede nating makita. At least lang, para lang malaman natin kung siya ay ma-detect ng laptop as a controller. Kasi if it does, then that is good news. And it does. So it is also a controller for your laptop. Okay, so if you have maybe a laptop lying around, a gaming laptop, you want to play some games, and you can also connect your smartphone, for example, my Magic V3, ko-connect ko siya rito. Gian, what's the purpose of that? Netflix or Disney Plus, I play a game while I'm also watching a movie, which is a pretty nice way of really enjoying. We're kind of used to doing that, playing on another PC or another screen and watching a movie on another screen. So yeah, that has been our quick video. Sana naging quick siya, no? Of the Gamesir G8 Plus. I seriously love this, except for the fact that it's not working on iOS 18. That remains to be checked later on. I'll give you some updates on my threads, Facebook, also on Instagram, if nag-work na siya, finally. No? That has been, of course, again, no, our quick demo. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. This has been GN of Gadget Pilipinas. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye!